Today is all about showing how wine appears to change in the air. And the trick really here is that the wine doesn't change at all, but you do. If you taste a glass of wine immediately after takeoff on a Los Angeles flight and then taste the same wine from a fresh bottle shortly before landing, 10 and a half, 11 hours later, there's a big, big difference in terms of the way you respond to it. We'd like to show you the wines here in a normal environment, and then we'd like to show you the same wines up at 30,000 feet and see what differences there are. If you understand how the wines are affected or appear to be affected, then you can take that into consideration. And what tends to happen is that if a wine is balanced at ground level, then it pretty much stays the same in the air. What we tend to look for are very fruit-driven styles of wine, so New World wines work extremely well. It was something we were aware of, but it seems to have taken on a new life, and British Airways has certainly started to own this kind of issue with Height Cuisine, with the Heston Blumenthal program recently. Wine fits into this very, very well indeed, because it's something we've always taken note of by choosing styles of wines that are robust enough to stand up to use on board. It's gone really well, and there's some distinct patterns emerging. And here we are 5 hours into the flight, when all the effects of pressurisation and all the different distractions that you're going to get in an aircraft environment are playing their full part.
I found myself quite liking, I'm not a Sauvignon Blanc fan, I prefer Chardonnay, and I thought the Sauvignon Blanc fed really well, high altitude, and I thought the Argentinian Malbec was superb, ground level and in the air.
The Bordeaux Claret was very tannic, very drying, and at this sort of altitude, because the tannins come forward so much, it seems that it's just going to work a lot better with food, and the cheddar really brought that out.
It certainly enables us to talk about this from a position of knowledge. We've actually come up here and done this, and not just done it on our own, we've done it with independent journalists. I think going forward, what we can look at doing is actually saying, try these wines. They might not be a wine that you taste particularly on the ground, but actually, it tastes an awful lot better at 30,000 feet.